Hey Jess, I'm in the mood for a good scare. You got any scary stories?
One night, on Halloween, three kids followed their grandmother onto a bus into an alternate dimension with creatures.
This sounds like the plot to Halloween Town, and that's not that scary.
What, you got anything better?
Hey guys, you're live!
Oh.
Good afternoon, St. Mike's. My name's Jessica.
And my name's Nathan.
And we're your hosts for the 2019 Halloween broadcast.
So, St. Mike's, are you ready for a real horror story? Turtles.
Scrunchies.
Plastic.
Ah!
Here's our first spook of the day, the invasion of the Visco Girls.
That a plastic straw?
Yeah, why?
Do you even know what that's doing to the environment?
It is killing the turtles. And without the turtles, there wouldn't be any turtles.
Yeah, but you know what? Like, it's okay. Like, don't even worry about it. You know what? It's fine. Like, I actually have an extra metal straw if you want to use it.
Okay. We gotta go.
Yeah, bye. Look, and I oop. I guess they never learn. Excuse me, what do you think you're doing?
You shouldn't be using those.
Yeah, we told you guys yesterday.
And I oop, I guess I forgot.
And I oop, no one cares.
And I hoop, and I oop.
The turtles. So,
we need to do something.
Don't even worry about it. I have a plan.
Wow, that really hit home. Save the turtles. Nathan, do you want one of my scrunchies?
Sure. Thanks. You know what's more basic than Visco Girls these days? Bob Ross tutorials.
Oh, I watched a Bob Ross tutorial last night and I painted you something. I'm gonna go get it. You, right here, wait.
Everyone thinks you're such a great artist after one tutorial. Anyways, we don't have any Bob Ross for you, but we do have his cousin Victor.
Hi, welcome back. I'm certainly glad you could join us. Unfortunately, I cannot be painting with you today, so my cousin Victor will be filling in. I hope you enjoy this episode, and please remember to be kind to him, because he will bite back in the comments below. 283 years sure can do a lot to a person.
Hello everyone, I am Bob's cousin Victor. Let's go ahead and put the color names on the screen so you can paint along with us. Yes. And today we are going to be painting something that reflects the greatest time of the year. Let's get started. We are going to be using this brush, I guess, to paint the background. Let's go in with our blood red and smear that on there. It? Wow! I am very good at this. What? Look at that. It looks like blood. I like it. Not that I would know, but it looks very much, very red. Alright, now we are going to get a new brush, okay, with some candy corn, orange, and paint. Paint and draw three overlapping circles. It is very chunky.
Very chunky. It looks like pumpkin guts. Perfect.
Okay, three overlapping circles. Aye, look at this. I am talented, no? Yes. It is very chunky. I don't know if this is okay. Now we are going to grab some beastly brown and do small little rectangle at the top of your circle. So, small little rectangle. And then we are going to take some black caps and paint triangles in the middle of your circles.
Oh, amazing, amazing.
And finally get some ghostly white and add in details.
What details?
You can add some highlights and maybe some shadows, whatever you really want. Oh, I have ideas. Yes, that looks very good. Okay, and now I think I am done. Bloody brilliant! No? I'd love to see a picture if you do one, so please send me it. From everyone here, happy painting and happy Halloween, my blood brothers!
Do you like it?
Yeah, that's something special, all right.
You want to know what's special? You, St. Mike's. Now we have a special spotlight of our favorite costumes this year.
Hey, St. Mike's. So I'm with some students who won the costume contest this year, who I must say look absolutely fantastic. But just for some clarification for some of viewers who do not know, what's your name, what grade are you in, and what did you dress up as this year?
All right, I'm Giuliano. I'm in grade 10, and I dress up as Dr. Doofensmirt and his beautiful wife.
Wow, I love it. And what about you?
I'm Adriano. I'm in grade 11. I dressed up as a mom.
Nice. And then, to my understanding, these guys are a joint costume. So, what show are you from, and what characters are you?
We're from Trailer Park Boys. I'm J-Rock, and my name's Michael.
I'm Bubbles, and my name's Roman.
I'm Julian, and my name's Justin.
Fantastic. So, I would assume that you guys have been planning this for quite a while, or was this something spontaneously that you thought of recently?
Me and my friends did think of kind of doing like a little group. So one of my other friends is Vanessa, so the daughter of Dr. Doofensmirtz, and she also created this beautiful masterpiece. Then her other friend is Candace.
Oh, nice. Thank you very much to you guys. And then what about you?
I just picked out some things and became a girl.
Yeah. When did you do this? Was this like last night or?
2 days.
2 days ago?
Yep.
Oh, wow. Okay. And then what about you guys?
We've been planning this since the beginning of the summer. It's been a while.
I'm sure you guys are pretty big fans of the show.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Okay, great. And then final question that we have. To my understanding, you guys are going off to, are going to be graduating this year. But do you have any idea? Are you guys going to dress up next year?
Yeah, we're going to get more boys to do the Trailer Park Boys with us.
Oh, great. And what about you?
Doofensmirtz, in one of his actual episodes, he was a gnome when he was a little child. So next year, I'm going to replicate that.
Okay, nice. And what about you?
I plan on putting more, makeup and better hair.
Wow, we're gonna bring her back?
And some shoes, yeah.
Okay, I'm sure we can't wait for that. Thank you so much to everyone who dressed up this year. Your participation is greatly appreciated, and back to you in the studio.
So, which one was your favorite, Nathan?
I really think that this beauty should have been the winner, but I guess I'm a little biased.
Yeah, I can tell you put a lot of effort into this one.
Hey, at least I put in more effort than those people who leave the take one bowls of candy on their porch on Halloween night.
Dre, drop it.
Hey, what's up, MiCTV? It's me again. Today, we're going to be exposing all the candy givers on my street. That's right. These are the worst houses on my street on Halloween. Go hide. This dude left the whole bowl outside. Okay, next house. Trick or treat! Oh, right, it's Halloween. One second. Here you go. Thank you. We got a garage. Hi there, happy Halloween.
Only one.
Happy Halloween!
Oh my god, you're so cute! When I was in the 8th grade, I was a cat. All the boys loved me. Do you want a candy? I bet you want a candy. They're so sweet. Every cat loves a good candy.
Ah! Ah! Delete that. That wasn't funny. This one's a winner. I can feel it. I skipped Halloween.
Recording me?
No. That's it for tonight, MiCTV. Happy Halloween.
Hey! Goodbye. Parental discretion is advised when a doc gets candid to move like a one-armed bandit. Arrange the tempo.
Wow. I really miss trick-or-treating now.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, Jess. Trick-or-treat.
Here you go.
Toothpaste? Are you kidding me? Toothpaste? Who can sell toothpaste on Halloween? That's not even okay, like... Well, that's better.
Wow, you really have a temper on you.
So I've been told.
What does that mean?
That stupid alarm. I don't know why I even bothered to go to sleep. It was 3:26. I had woken up enough times in the middle of the night to get my timing down to a science. Get out of bed, change my pajamas, grab my backpack, and get on my bike to leave. 19 minutes, every time. If I woke up exactly at 3:26, I can get there at 3:45 exact. Our town was small, shoved in the corner between two major cities, like an annoying middle child. If you're lucky enough to find a map with Mahogany Creek on it, drive on down and embrace the crisp fall air and skies blessed not to be ruined by pollution yet. Like every small town, the creek's origins are rooted in a true small town tale. It differs based on who you ask, but the oldest in the town will tell you the stories of the demise of the kids on Hollows Hill. Story goes, a group of children were planning to run away from the creek. Their parents were wealthy and too unobservant to notice the kids missing from their beds at night. They followed the river's edge to a clearing in the woods, where the son of the town's barber met them. The boy was the oldest of the group, taller than the rest of them. Days had gone by, and the kids started to notice they appeared to be walking in circles, as the sound of the creek could still be heard rushing near them. The kids grew hungry, becoming increasingly more aggressive. They blamed the son of the barber for getting them lost and lying to them. With words exchanged and fist thrown, the barber's son picked up a nearby stone, and with one fatal throw, the group of five dwindled to four. Two of the children, terrified of the horror they had let lead them through the crawling vines and wicked trees, they ran, silently. Like ghosts of children, they used to be only to never be seen again. And with that, the town's grand clock rang. Morning was breaking. The daughter of the florist stayed, young and blonde, staring at the body before her. Why didn't she scream? Why didn't she run away? What happened to the boy? After the police found the boy's body in the woods, the barber's son, well, some think he skipped town, but more creative minds think he still lives on, following the rushing of the creek.
Yeah, okay, we've all heard that story. We all know it's not true.
Yeah, like, I'm so scared some tall little 8-year-old's gonna come out and hit me in the back of the neck with a stick.
Well, hey, if you're looking for weak, tall kids, you should be more scared of Miles. He's got, like, a full foot on you.
Hey, I was just trying to bring some nostalgia to the group. Aren't you scared of the little flower girl peeking through the trees?
Yeah, what's with that story anyways? Tell me those kids just vanished. They probably just starved anyways.
Or, easy explanation, the story never happened. I mean, I've heard so many versions where the barber son planned on killing all of them, or the stupid girl told him to blah, blah, blah. Like, it's all nonsense.
What about the version where all the kids turned to zombies? That one's way better.
All right, forgive me my old town ways. I'm getting through. So this was the club. Sam, club founder, president of the Hates Her Parents Club and the Way Out of My League Club. Followed by Liam, the classic movie fanatic and Ivy League math student. Next, you've got Arizona and Josh, your made-for-TV John Hughesian couple, with the gross factor that Arizona was my sister. You round out the group with me, Miles, the tall kid who rides his bike everywhere and is known for riding of all things. We were a sad crew, but a crew nonetheless. And this was our Thursday, every Thursday at 3:45 a.m. We sat, we talked, said stupid things, played stupid games, ate way too much food, and put off the fact that soon, we'd all be gone. I set my alarm for 5:13. With as many times as I had done this, I could get home just before my parents got up.
So what are we doing this morning?
Why don't we go jump in the creek again, like we did last summer?
Hello, it's March. I'm not trying to freeze. How about we just break into the school again or something?
Please, like I want to spend any more time there than I already do.
Guys, don't you realize that like we only have a couple more months here with like jobs and university applications and exams, and we won't be able to do this that much after.
Jeez, Sam, what a damn good move. I feel so old now.
No, Sam's right. We don't really have a lot of time left together. We should make it count. What's something that we used to do as kids?
I used to hit my sister in the head with a foam bat till she screamed.
You know, Miles, as appealing as that sounds, I was thinking something more along the lines of something we could all do together.
I've got it.
Remember when we used to play trick or dare as little kids?
Yeah. Okay, yeah, sure. Just let me go grab something first.
I'll help you.
Okay, yes. I've known Sam since we were six, and some might say I'm mildly in love with her, but I know that's hopeless, and she's off to some smart kid school next year anyways.
So how are you feeling about this?
Sorry.
I mean, it's pretty normal to feel sad knowing that your whole life is gonna change.
I mean, it's whatever. We're still gonna be close, right?
Did you hear that?
Yeah, maybe it's the barber's son. You're to kill us all.
Shut up.
Start this up.
Yeah, who's first?
Got it. Liam, truth or dare?
Easy, dare.
So time went on, and the cliche truth and dares rolled out, and the secret spilled, the morning was drawing near.
Miles.
Sorry, I was just,
It's your turn.
Okay. Arizona. Truth or dare?
Truth.
Okay. Tell us your biggest secret.
Oh, easy. I was the one that sold Raposo's test to everyone.
So you're telling me that's your biggest secret?
Oh, come on. We know it's not your biggest secret. You sell everybody that.
Guys, I just really
don't... Oh, come on. We're all friends.
Yeah, come on. Just tell us. It's okay.
Guys, come on. Just let her be.
Don't be lame. Just say it.
Okay. Well, okay, come on, guys. We don't have to do this.
Why? You got a secret?
Josh, stop.
No. What do you have to say? What is this?
Josh, I'm... really sorry. It happened last October.
Are you kidding me?
Josh, it was a mistake. It was a one-time thing, and it was at a party.
I really don't want to.
Josh,
okay?
Josh,
you need to calm down. I think it's time to go home.
Man, and what?
Guys, stop.
Seriously, calm down.
Miles.
Josh, I think
guys,
you can go
home.
We're gonna take your side.
Miles.
Screw you, Miles.
Guys,
screw you.
Stop.
Cut it out.
Guys, you need
what
to
are you
stop.
Gonna do?
Guys, stop it. Stop.
Guys,
stop.
Miles,
guys,
stop.
Miles. Miles, what the hell is wrong with you?
Guys, we need to get out. Let's go. Let's go.
Josh,
come on.
Welcome back. Did I scare you?
No, but you know what really scares me?
I don't really care, but I do want to know what scares you, St. Mike's.
Here's our question of the week.
When I'm home alone?
Yes.
Oh, a door shut by itself.
That is pretty scary. You?
Oh, that's a hard one. My family coming home.
Yeah, that's pretty scary.
Nothing happens to me because I'm the priest. So, I'm pretty blessed.
Fair enough.
This is from the summertime.
Right?
So, I was at home, I checked the mail, and I was rifling through all the letters, and then it came. The dreaded credit card bill.
One time we were home alone, me and my friends, and our other friends ran around my house knocking on the windows, pretending like we were getting robbed.
Yeah,
that's pretty scary.
We played the Ouija board together and our window broke.
That's pretty scary. Thank you for coming out.
And I opened it up, and what I saw was so shocking. It was super, super high. I couldn't believe it. That's when a knock came at the door. I went and I opened it up. It was the Amazon delivery man. And he had tons and tons and tons of orders from Amazon Prime Day. And he kept coming and going to his truck to get more and more boxes. So let that be a lesson to you. Avoid Amazon Prime Day, because it would make your credit card bill shoot all the way to the top and give you a great scare.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for telling us this amazing story.
Thank you.
The dog going to the door and scratching.
How about you?
I was watching a horror movie and then the power went out and the furnace stopped working.
That is pretty scary. Thank you for coming out.
You're welcome.
A crazy psycho person came to my door and started banging on it. And I was with friends, and it was kind of scary.
That sounds pretty scary. You?
I was home alone and I was just on my couch and someone rang the doorbell and I got really scared. So I got a knife from my kitchen and I answered the door, but it was just a mailman, so it was okay.
Cool, thank you for saying your stories.
Hi, I'm Jack and I'm here interviewing the host. So, what was the scariest thing that happened to you while you were home alone?
Well, you see, I play a lot of Xbox. And so I'm downstairs, I'm playing my console, and for some reason, whenever I'm really into the game, I can hear footsteps right above me. And where I am in the basement, it's right above the where we eat dinner, right? So every so often I go up there and check if anything has moved. It's perfectly fine up there. I don't know what happens.
That is super strange. Thank you for coming out.
Before we leave you this Halloween, here's a special treat from your teachers, St. Mike's.
Okay, everyone, any questions for tomorrow's assignment? No? Okay, well, have a good day.
Have a good night, sir.
Okay, Sandro, through the front doors, there really isn't any time to stop at your locker. Seasons have changed, you know? So it's quick out the door and home, please and thank you. Have a good weekend. What are you doing here, man? It's late. You're not supposed to be here. It's my shift tonight.
Relax, man. It's still early. I just finished the meeting.
Lower your voice! Don't you know the seasons have changed? What are you doing?
I'm leaving.
No, it's late. Stay. You don't want to go out there, trust me.
It's still early. Don't get bent out of shape. Nothing to worry.
And that's your broadcast for today, St. Mike's. On behalf of MiCTV, we wish you all a safe and haunted Halloween.